Okay, in this lecture, we will study about a very, very important term to design a classifier, okay, that is called as random forest, okay, that is called as your random forest, okay. So, before that, I want to give an example of what is called as a random forest, okay, because that is very important to know what is called as a random forest, okay. So random forest means the collection of decisions, okay, and a decision in a forest is called as a tree, okay. So we can call a random forest as a collection of decision trees, okay. So basically, to design a random forest, we require to design a tree, okay, by which we can classify the patterns or take a decision, okay. So that is the simple fundamental of random forest and what is a decision tree. So later on, I will teach you what is a random forest and what is a decision tree. So before that, I want to solve a example. Okay, that example is totally based on a designing decision tree. So if you design a decision tree, then you can make many decision trees, and that collection is known as a random forest. Okay. So for that, we first understand this problem, okay, this example, what it says, okay. So here a data set is given, so this is the input to the machine, okay. We use the random forest or the decision tree for learning, okay, for learning purpose. So this is the data set we will take and update the machine in which situation what happens. And after knowing or building a classifier, okay, by taking the input sets, and finally if some new input will come, then it will decide whether that event will happen or not by learning using decision tree, okay. So for that the example is designed as follows, okay. Here you can see a term day is there, okay. So day, outlook, temperature, wind, and the final one is play, okay. So basically what we need to know is that that whether we are going to play if the conditions are like this, okay. So here you see I have given a data set of 14 days. You can capture this example in your photos or in your copies or like that, so that you can further use it for the design, because I have now seen this one, shown this one, and after in the description of random forest, I will just delete it from here or rub it from here. So just make a copy of this in your record book or in your snapshot, so that for further problem solving it is easier for you, okay. So you can see I have given a data pattern of 14 days, okay. And what is the outlook means whether it is sunny. Then this one is called the sunny is there here, and then overcast and rain is there. So here rain, so that, and the temperature is given, that is high than normal. So it has two attributes only, high and normal. And outlook has three outputs that are sunny, overcast and rain. Wind has weak or strong, okay. So weak or strong. And play means here you can see no means he is not playing. If in day one sunny is there, temperature is high and wind speed is weak, then he is not playing. But in the condition of overcast, when the temperature is high and wind is also there, then he is playing. So many types of combinations are there. We are just inputting these combinations to the machine, and the machine will use a learning algorithm that is called as a decision tree, by which for the new inputs, suppose a new input will come, whether sunny is there, low temperature is there, wind is strong, then he will play or not, we will decide. So basically we now understand what is the problem. So we have to design a classifier using the decision tree so that we can predict whether the person will further play or not if the conditions are like this. Okay, so now I am rubbing it from here. Okay, so basically you have already know what is a decision tree. So now I am going to design a tree, a small example of a tree. So this is called the root node. Okay, and then these are called the internal nodes. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and these are called the 4, 5, 6, 7. These are called the decision label nodes. Okay, here decision label nodes means this is called as a leaf node. Okay, in the leaf node, after the leaf node, there will be no separation. Okay, of the data. So this is the final decision we are taking, means whether he is playing or not in this part. Okay. So we will discuss till so note here, we will discuss till which part, okay, this leaf node will come. Okay, after which time this leaf node will come and we will extend our tree. That is the main problem. So we will solve that using a example. I have given the data set to you. Now I am going directly to the problem. Okay. Okay, so here you can see I am designing Outlook. Okay, and Outlook has three parts. One is sunny, and the other one is overcast, and the third one it is called as windy. Okay. So here you can see that when the conditions are sunny, overcast or windy, after seeing the data set what I have provided earlier, so we will decide here whether the whether if it is only sunny, then he will play or not. So here there are for that we will see whether he will play on not. Okay, for that we will see how much time he is playing. So in play I am writing play and not playing. Okay, so play is 2 here, 3 here. So here play is 4 here and not playing it is 0. So here your play is 3 and not playing is 2. Getting? So here we can see, okay, in sunny he is playing as well as not playing. Okay, that means that this condition is called as the uncertain condition. Uncertain condition means this set can be further divided so that we can know whether he is playing or not playing, because till this case we don't know in which conditions he is playing and not playing. So this is called an uncertain T case, and he is not means if it is sunny we cannot say, okay, he is playing or not. So this is not a certain case, but here you can see this is a certain case. Means whenever the condition or the outlook is overcast, the person is playing 4 times and not playing 0 time. Means that this is called as, this term is called as pure subset. Okay, pure subset means after this no further division is there. Okay, so our main goal is to find pure subset in which we can know whether he is totally playing or totally not playing. So this is the condition, because you can see this not playing is 0. Okay, so here it is 2 and 3, means here the condition is uncertain. Okay, so like the same here also it is uncertain. So now this node will not further divided, but these nodes will be further divided to generate a pure subset. Getting? So for that, okay, what we will do here, in Sunny we can further divide it into, okay, two part. That is, first part is temperature is high and temperature is normal. Okay, temperature is high, temperature is normal. Okay, after setting this we are finding that, okay, we are finding the labels like play is 2, not play is 0, play is 0, not playing is 3. Okay, so you can see that when the temperature is high means this person is not playing, so this is called a pure subset. So after this no division will be there. So this is the last and this is the leaf node. This is the leaf node, this is the leaf node, this is the leaf node, this one you can see is also a pure subset. Okay, here PS means pure subset, LN means leaf node. Okay, so in windy case we can do one thing. Okay, that is two cases are there. One is strong wind and one is weak wind. Okay, so in strong wind we will get a condition, okay, that play is 3 times, not playing 0. Okay, then here play is 0 and not playing is 2. Getting? So it is the leaf node and this is also the leaf node. Okay, so this is also the pure subset, this is also the pure subset. So these are the decision labels. Okay, so after this no further division will occur. Okay, so from here we can see, okay, so how many times the person is playing, that is more important to us. So here we can see that 9 yes is there. Okay, sorry, okay, here we can see that 9 yes is there and not playing conditions are 5 nodes are there. So this is our final. From this chart we can see that you can add the 2 plus 2 4, 4 plus 4 8, and then 8 plus 8, then 8 plus 3, that is called something there is something error is there. Okay, you can check it. Okay, you will get this work 9 by 5 n. okay, some error is there here. Okay, I've done it, so you can personally do it, do the problem and solve it. So then you will get 9 yes and 5 no's here. Okay, because when in this problem I am adding 2, this 2, okay, this 2, okay, 2, I have added this, so we will take this one, sorry. Okay, 2 plus 4 is 6. Okay, 6 plus 3 is 9. Okay, so I am getting it, sorry. Okay, and now the not playing conditions are not playing here. You can see 2 is there and 3 is there, so that is 5. Okay, so this is a very easy problem. and we can solve it. So this is the convergence point at which the problem is stopping by finding the pure subset. So by this problem, no error is there, sorry, in the middle part, okay, no error is there, some in calculation I have done something, okay, so it is totally correct. And you can go through this. It is a very easy problem and very important problem for learning a machine and to find the find a classifier using the data set what I have provided and using the decision tree. Okay, so now I will do one thing. I will solve a problem by giving a new input. Okay, so if windy is yes, if windy is strong, okay, and temperature is low, okay, or normal, okay, it is strong, and outlook is rainy, so whether he will play or not. If windy is strong, temperature is low or normal, outlook is rainy, then he will play or not. How to find it? So we have to go for outlook first. So outlook is rainy means we will go to the rainy part. Okay. I have written it windy, but it is rainy. Okay, just correct it. This is rainy. Okay. So in rainy, the winds are from rainy we are getting okay here you do one thing. Okay, this only normal or this actually it is break into temperature, okay, and this rainy will actually go into this one, okay, that is wind. Now it is all right. Okay, now you can understand it. Okay, this because our problem is rainy, okay, so we have to go to the rainy. Okay, then rainy part I have gone to the rainy part, then temperature is not coming here. Okay, then I will go to the wind, which is strong. So in strong we can see that playing is 0 and not playing is 2. So the ultimate goal, the ultimate result is he is not going to play. So NP the answer. Okay, so this is the prediction model I have designed. Okay, so if the condition is this, then the person will not play. So this is a very very easy problem. You can solve it very easily by yourself. And thank you.